Did you see a dog out there? No. This was a specific one. The blacksmith is offering a reward for a dog he saw on the road. I was hoping you'd seen it. I guess I'll stay on the lookout. Keep your nose clean while you're here, outsider.
Unless you intend to bury someone, this isn't the place you're looking for, traveler. Falkraith is known for its graveyard, traveler. We've buried more dead than you can imagine. I just finished giving my old war companion Barrett a proper burial by fire. Old Hardhead hated the idea of being lost cold in the ground. Could you deliver the ashes to Runil, the priest of Arkay? He'll know the right blessings to make for Barrett's soul. Thank you. Till next time.
Take a good look around. I'm sure you'll find what you're looking for. If not, let me know. I might have it stored away. Well met. Unlike my brother, I've no dislike of strangers. Met lots of them while I was a Stormcloak. His name's Bolin. He's the one who works the lumber mill down by the river. If you meet him, don't expect much in the way of conversation. He ain't one for talking, especially with folk he don't know. I was once, but not anymore. I was wounded in a skirmish up near Windhelm. This was years ago, mind you. Now maybe I don't pick up a blade in Ulfric's name no more, but I still hold with his ideals. Skyrim is Nordland, and we ought to rule it. We don't need no help from the Empire on that count. Steal anything from my shop and you'll regret it.
Shorts bones, handsome man in Falkrie. The strong drink will chase off that chill in the air. I've half a mind to ask if you'll take me on one of your adventures, but I can't just leave Valga on her own.
Yes, what is it that you want? Now we'll see if the stories about you are true. There's a group of bandits in my hold that I may have had a few discreet dealings with. The cut they were giving me was good at first, but now it's time to clean things up. Go and take care of it. Good. My uncle Dengir was Jarl until a short time ago. His old age and failing health caught up with him, and he stepped down. He now serves us honorably as Thane, and to the great benefit of the Hold, I now serve as Jarl. Difficult. I'm a Jarl. I eat the most succulent meat, drink the finest ale, and hunt with the best hounds in the Hold. Meanwhile, my very capable steward sees to the needs of the small folk, and ensures that my hold runs smoothly. Being a Jarl could hardly be simpler. You should try it sometime. Execute every last bandit. Spare no one.
Exactly hidden, you know. This again? I told you. someone standing guard out there. Don't forget the rock trap we rigged up. So, stop your worrying and get some rest. Your shift is coming up and I don't want you dozing off again like last time.
Someone there?
I wonder what it's like for those Thalwall now that they've been taken down a notch.
Good to see you. Finally, someone useful is around. Teach them to stop paying me. Here, you deserve a reward for your service. You know what? I like you. You're not afraid to get your hands dirty. I hereby grant you permission to purchase property in Falkreath Hold. Talk to my steward if you're interested. There is room in my court for a new fame. It's an honorary title mainly, but There are a few perks someone like you could make use of. However, I could only grant the title to someone who is known throughout my hold. You help my people, and I'll make you my thane. On your way, then. Come and see me again sometime. I might have some use for you.
There's no house available, but I could sell you a fine piece of land where you could build your own house. You won't regret it. Here's the title to your steady. Follow the road east from Falkreath, then north at the crossroads. Turn left just past Pinewatch. Many battles have been fought here over the centuries. Graves were dug and monuments built, and the town grew around these. In time, Falkreath came to be known as the Hero's Graveyard. Many noble jarls and renowned warriors asked to be buried here. Falkreath's reputation has faded somewhat, but the graves remain, reminding us of the one inevitable truth of life. It was Dengir who made me a steward, long ago when he was young. When Dengir's health began to fail, young Sidgir was appointed Jarl in his stead. It was simpler just to keep me as steward. Sidgir has no interest in running his hold, and so leaves such matters to me. As for my part, I do my best to see that folk are treated fairly. May wisdom forever light your path.
Yes, what is it that you want? Bolin speaks much about the war and the Stormcloaks, but he knows who provides. Then by my right as Jarl, I name you Thane of Falkreath. Congratulations. I grant you a personal housecarl, and this weapon from my armory to serve as your badge of office. I'll also notify my guards of your new title. Wouldn't want them to think you're part of the common rabble now.
The Jarl has appointed me to be your housecarl. It's an honor to serve you.
Lead on, Thane. My blade is always yours to command.
What's the Jarl going to do about it?
How are we supposed to feel safe in our own homes?
Please, enough already. I have told Ygritte of your concerns. She'll look after you all. Please, go about your business.
We've no need for wizards in our midst.
Morthal has enough problems as it is.
It's no use. Let's get back to it then.
I'm the best warrior in Morthal, and that's no boast. You want me to prove it? I bet 100 gold I can take you, barehanded. Just your own two hands. Weapons and magic are out. Now let's see what you got. Come on, let's see what you're made of. Just die! You're a real fighter. I like that. You ever need my steel by your side, you just ask. You've been a good friend to me. That means something. Oh, well, you know, a bit of this, a bit of that. They haven't made me a guard, even though I've been asking. So I'll take odd jobs, anything that comes along for now. Mm-hmm.
You need to leave. If you've business with the Jarl, I'd ask that you speak to me first. That's what many here wanted. A quiet life in a quiet place, without the noise or the trouble of a city. Now some worry this wizard Falion will foul it all up. Ah, you saw that, did you? Life in Morthal has been troubled lately. The people are uncertain, restless. merely look to the Jarl for leadership.
There's news of rebellion against the Empire.
Strange noises have been heard in the marshes at night.
And then, the tragedy with Rogar's home.
The men simply seek wisdom. Everything will be fine.
I'll take my leave then.
So, life has brought you to Morthal, and to me. What purpose this serves, we will no doubt see. Welcome. Tamriel is full of wisdom and magic, if one is willing to look for it. Few have their eyes open. That which is unknown can create unease, even fear. It is to be expected. Some fear our new resident wizard. As they grow to know him, they will accept him. Time will prove me right. I stand where I have always stood, here in Morthal. Now is not the time to fight amongst ourselves. I fear dark days approach, and all of Skyrim's strength will be needed. The Divines reveal things to me at times, yes. I do not hide this. It is a gift. Anyone who believes otherwise does not and cannot understand it.
If you've business with the Jarl, I'd ask that you speak to me first.
How can I help a brother north?
Please don't mind Yorick. He's not mad. Really, he's not. My brother is sensitive. He has trouble focusing his attention on things. We were taking him to the Temple of Kinnereth in Whiterun, just so the healers could make sure he was in good health. And they say he's fine. Are you heading to Whiterun? Could you take this letter to the priestess, Danica Purespring? It's a note about Yorick's health. Thank you. Until next time.
If you've business with the Jarl, I'd ask that you speak
to me first. Tamriel is full of wisdom and magic, if one is willing to look for it. Few have their eyes open. Rogar's house fire? Well, he lost his wife and daughter in the blaze. My people believe it to be cursed now. Who am I to gainsay them? Rogar blames his wife for spilling bear fat in the fire. Many folk think he set the fire himself. Lust can make a man do the unthinkable. The ashes were still warm when he pledged himself to Alva. On rumor and gossip? No. But you, a stranger, might find the truth for us. Sift through the ashes that others are too fearful to touch. See what they tell you. Should you prove him guilty or innocent, I will reward you. Rogar's fate is in your hands.
I have to wonder, what does...
Who's there? Is that you, Father? Helgi, but Father says I'm not supposed to talk to strangers. Are you a stranger? You know him? He made my favorite dolly, but I can't find her. Are you sure you aren't a stranger? The smoke woke me up. I was hot and I was scared, so I hid. Then it got cold and dark. I'm not scared anymore, but I'm lonely. Will you play with me? Okay. Let's play hide-and-seek. You find me, and I'll tell you. We have to wait for nighttime, though. The other one is playing, too, and she can't come out until then. I can't tell you. She might hear me. She's so close. If you can find me first, I can tell you. You found me! Laylat was trying to find me too, but I'm glad you found me first. Laylat was told to burn Mommy and me, but she didn't want to. She wanted to play with me forever and ever. She kissed me on the neck, and I got so cold that the fire didn't even hurt. Laylat thought she could take me and keep me, but she can't. I'm all burned up. I'm tired. I'm gonna sleep for a while now.
Laylat. She's dead. Laylat is dead. Laylat. I thought she left to join the Stormcloaks. Oh, my poor Laylat. She began to spend a lot of time with Alva. Yet just a week before, she despised her. In fact, the night she disappeared, she was supposed to meet Alva. Alva told me later that she never showed up. I never got to tell her goodbye. You think Alva? But that means... Ye gods! You think Alva is a vampire? No, you're wrong. You must be wrong. Laylat may have met her fate out in the marsh. I refuse to believe Alva had anything to do with this. There is no way you can prove it to the Jarl. I hope Alva is not what you think.
Gods gave you two hands, and you use them both for your weapon. I can respect that.
Tamriel is full of wisdom. Is Hrogar innocent or not? Alva? Huh, didn't think she had it in her. I assume you have proof? Can't go making accusations like that without proof. So it's true. The traitorous bitch. Morthal owes you a debt. Here, you were promised a reward for solving the crime, but I need one more favor from you. Morthal is still in danger. The journal mentions Movarth, a master vampire I thought was destroyed a century ago. I'll gather together some able-bodied warriors to clean out Movarth's lair. They'll be waiting outside for you to lead them. Till next time.
Take us to Movarth's lair.
Take us?
Yeah.
Kill the vampire.
Kill him.
Kill him.
Destroy him.
Please don't mind Yorick.
She's dead.
Really, he's not.
I want vengeance for my wife. Vengeance for Laylat! We're marching on Movarth's lair, whether you come with us or not! I'm just a poor man trying... They may be cowards, but I'm not. I'll go with you. I suppose you're right. I'm not a fighting man. Go! and avenge my lay left for me.
Mm-hmm.
Take this coin purse off your hands for you. Those nice boots you've got there.
What was that?
Mother's calling me. It's time for me to sleep now. I'm so tired. Thank you for making her feel better.
You look sick. I hope it's not contagious. By the Eight, I didn't think he could do it. Now maybe we can put all this behind us. Take this as a token of our gratitude. There is room in my court for a new Thane. It's an honorary title mainly, but there are a few perks someone like you could make use of. However, I could only grant the title to someone who is known throughout my home. You help my people, and I'll make you my Thane. Good luck. All right then. Well, look at you. If only everyone acted like you did. Tamriel is full. Then by my right as Jarl, I name you Thane of Hjalmarch. Congratulations. I grant you this weapon from my armory to serve as your badge of office. I'll also notify my guards of your new title. Wouldn't want them to think you're part of the common rabble now. Mm-hmm.
The Jarl has appointed me to be your housecarl. It's an excellent. Lead on, Thane.
Let me guess. Someone stole your sweet roll.
Bit of jewelry for your journey home?
Oh, this pendant would look lovely on my sister.
To the
Victory is yours. I submit.
Yes, it's all clear.
Die for my people.
By the divine, another body to get rid of. In the city.
Everyone, stay back. The Markarth City Guard have this all under control. There are no Forsworn here.
Gods. A woman attacked right on the streets. Are you all right? Did you see what happened? I'm so sorry. I hope the Eight give you more peace in the future.
Oh, I think you dropped this. Some kind of note. Looks important.
My note? No, that's yours. Must have fallen out of your pocket. No. I was just getting some fresh air. Had one too many pints of mead at the Silver Blood Inn. I'd better get going.
To be an adventurer like you, and I took an arrow in the knee.
Priest, I'm not hiding anything. It's closed for a reason.
What are you hiding, priest?
I'm not hiding anything. It's closed for a reason.
Typical Imperial lies. First, you take away Talos. Now you're keeping us from seeing our honor dead? You and the Jarl will answer for any desecration of my ancestors' bodies.
That's enough, Thongvor. We're done.
You there. You another Imperial puppet? Answer me.
There's a war on, and you don't know what I'm talking about. The Empire is destroying everything Skyrim stands for. Jarl Igmund can refuse to see me all he wants. The Silverblood family will be heard. That's a true Nord hero. A legend. So great that the Divines themselves lifted his soul into the heavens and made him a god. He founded the Empire, and now they've turned their back on him to appease the Elves. Elves. Do the Elves rule Skyrim, or do the Nords? They started the Great War, nearly destroyed the Imperial City. Then the Emperor took the coward's way out and surrendered. Now the Elves dictate everything we do, and they don't want us acknowledging a mere human like Dalos as the god he is. We own Cidna Mine, best prison in Skyrim, and source of half the wealth in this city. We keep the Reach safe. We flood Markarth with wealth. But does the Jarl listen to us when we want to say? No. He's busy forgetting that Ulfric Stormcloak saved this city from the Forsworn. Ulfric's a hero, not a damn criminal. He used the Thune, shouted those Forsworn from the walls. Then he led a band of Nord warriors in to take the city. Just like Talos himself at the Battle of Old Hroldan, reclaiming the Reach from those heathen natives. Stay out of trouble in my city.
Excavation site is closed. I don't need any more workers or guards. Nishuan Zell? The ruins underneath Markarth? The wealth of artifacts that I've based two human lifetimes of research on? You idiot! Do you even know who I am? The most recognized scholar on the Dwemer in all of Tamriel. And you people keep bothering me. I'm sorry, I got too excited. I'm in the middle of some very stressful work, and I shouldn't have yelled. How can I help you? Excellent. I think you'll be glad that you made this decision. If you change your mind, you know where to find me. Yes, their history and culture is all around us in Markarth, a race of stonecutters, artisans, and engineers. They invented machines and built elaborate underground cities where they researched powers to rival the gods themselves. And then, at a time we are still not sure when, they disappeared. The whole people, all at once, leaving behind only their works. To protect my research, for one. There are more cutthroat scholars out there who would steal my findings if they got the chance. And the excavations into Nishuan Zell are dangerous. Dwemer machines and traps still function, even after thousands of years. Persistent, aren't you? Oh, very well. Who am I to stand in the way of curiosity? I'll let you in if you agree to something for me. There's a giant spider in Nishuan Zell. My workers call her Nimhi, the poisoned one. If you deal with Nimhi, I'll let you into both the excavation site and my Dwemer museum. What do you say? Enthusiasm. Good. Here's the key to the dig site. What? Oh, goodbye.
Don't let my uncle go on about his theories. He'll be here all night. I'm afraid to touch half the things we keep in the tower.
Dominion is here, and we're watching you. You have the honor of addressing a member of the Thalmor. Bask in it. We're the ruling body of the Old Mary Dominion. Saviors of Myr. Victors of the Great War. The Empire exists because we allow it to exist. And I'm here to make sure the Jarl of Markarth remembers that. The Thalmor saved all of Elvenkind during the Oblivion Crisis. We've been watching over our lands for 200 years. We refounded the Old Mary Dominion, an alliance between us and our Bosmer cousins. You might know them from their common name, Wood Elves. We intend to prove the superiority of Myr over man, one century at a time. As if this craggy wretch of a city could give birth to a superiorly bred Myr such as myself. No, I'm not from Markarth. I was sent here to lead the Thalmor's interests in this corner of Skyrim. It's my mission to root out all Talos worship in this city. It's a religious matter. The Thalmor do not recognize Talos as a god. He was only a man, and does not deserve a place in our pantheon. The Empire has agreed to accept our beliefs, and its citizens have a responsibility to cease their heretical worship. You're awfully inquisitive, aren't you? I like that. Perhaps you'd care to solve a little problem I'm having. Ogmund the Scald. He's old, respected, and I know for a fact that he worships Talos in his home. But the Jarl has been hesitant to call for his arrest. I want you to break into his home and find evidence. Ondolomar is the commander of the Thalmor in Markarth.
We're here to see the Jarl. No sudden moves. Understand?
Who are you to approach the Jarl of Markarth? Very well. You may approach the Mournful Throne. But watch your words. Keep your eyes open for Forsworn when you're on the roads.
You speak to Ygmunt, son of Hrothgar, Jarl of Markarth.
Stupid dog.
Yes, I know. We have some advantages if they come here. The city is built into the mountainside, so it's hard to reach into, even from the skies. And everything is made of stone, even the beds. We'll have no trouble from Dragon's Fire here. It all started here, this rebellion. When the Empire lost the Reach during the Great War, we became desperate. We promised a group of Nord militia free worship in exchange for their help retaking the Hold. Then the Elves found out about it. We were forced to arrest all of them. Ulfric Stormcloak, their leader, used the whole thing as proof that the Empire had abandoned Skyrim. The rebels called it the Markarth Incident. It was the founding day for the Stormcloaks, and where this war really started. The White Gold Concordant, our treaty with the Elves after the Great War, forbids free worship of Talos. But that's what we promised Ulfric and his men. It seems foolish looking back. But at the time, we were hoping the Elves wouldn't find out. So when they did find out, it was either we arrest Ulfric and the militia, or enter into yet another war with the Old Mary Dominion. The choice was clear. And now, Ulfric threatens the thinly veiled peace we sacrificed so much for. When the Aldmeri Dominion invaded the Imperial City, the Legion all but turned a blind eye to the other provinces. Many of the disgruntled natives of the Reach used the opportunity to depose the Empire and founded what they called an independent kingdom. It was little more than a chaotic uprising, but the Reach was removed from Imperial authority for 2 years before we reclaimed it. But the leaders of the uprising refused our offers of peace. They fled into the hills and became the Forsworn. My guards told me. Poor Margaret. And witnesses report that the attacker was shouting some nonsense about being a Forsworn. I want to make things clear. Markarth has its troubles, but there are no Forsworn in this city. They are only a threat in the hills and along the roads where they live. Everywhere else, we are in control. I don't know you, and I don't sell what precious property we have to outsiders. But if you're willing to work, and you prove to be reliable, I might deem you worthy to live here. My steward will handle things from there. If you'll excuse me, I have a city to run.
I'm Igman's uncle, as well as his steward. The Jarl has put out a bounty on Forsworn. Here. Take a look at this decree for details. I have letters to read.
As his housecarl, Igman's security is my chief concern. Igman's father was killed by Forsworn. I won't rest until they've paid with their blood.
Victory is yours.
dwarven city underneath the keep. The Schuenzel. Best steer clear if you don't want a steam centurion carving you up.
The Thor will know how to deal with Talos worshippers.
Rayrek, how is the Reach Ferry against this Forsworn menace?
Things are bad, Eamon. Our forces are barely able to keep the Forsworn in check. Merchants are reporting the loss of more of their shipments.
This is why I say we take the fight to them. Gather the Legion and drive those blasted beasts out of the Reach for good.
And what do Legion soldiers know about the hills of the Reach and the caves that make up those hills? The Forsworn can hide and ambush every assault.
The safety of the city and our settlements must be our only concern, Ignat. The rest of the Reach is on its own.
Cowards, both of you. My father would not sit idly back and wait while evil men take over his lands. We're done discussing this for now. Treat my people fairly, and I will do the same to you. Excellent. You've done us a great service. Here is your reward. Are you a sellsword? I don't like your kind. No honor, no loyalty, unreliable. But I can't turn away a potential ally in these times. Let's see if you're better than a common mercenary. My scouts have tracked down one of the Forsworn leaders, hiding out in their blood-soaked camps. Deal with them. We will see. I want no mercy for those Forsworn. Understand?
Ignat, we need to talk about the Silverblood family.
What about them? They seem loyal enough.
Loyal? Thangvor supports Ulfric and his Stormcloaks. We should imprison the entire family as a precaution.
I second that, Ignat. Who knows what that family will do for power? They could be working with the Forsworn for all we know.
Enough. We can't imprison the very people that own the jail we'll be throwing them into. The Silverblood family are to be left alone. Am I clear?
Yes,
my Jarl.
Silverblood family will be heard.
Ondolimar is the commander of the Thalmor in Markarth. Worship of Talos is strictly forbidden. Worship of Talos is strictly forbidden.
Good to have you by my side, friend. I need reliable people around. I'm impressed. Forsworn usually makes short work of mercenaries, but you took care of them. Here is your reward. If you'll excuse me, I have a city to run.
I'm Igman's uncle, as well as his steward. The Jarl has put out a bounty on Forsworn. Here, take a look at this decree for details. I have letters to read.
staying safe, I hope. They're in the city. We fight them where they live. We won't have to fight them here.
They live here too, my yarl. That's what I'm telling you. I'm Igman's uncle, as well as his steward. Excellent. You've done us a great service. Here is your reward. I have letters to read. I advise Igman the same way I advised his father. Caution, caution, caution.
Treat my people fairly, and I will do the same to you. If you'll excuse me, I have a city to run.
As his house, Carl, Igman's security is my chief concern.
Treat my people fairly, and I will do the same to you. I'll take my leave then.
Well, need something?
Forsworn have troubled the Reach for too long. I intend to deal with them. Mm-hmm. How can I help a brother? Doesn't matter. Treat my people fairly, and I will do the same to you. You've honored my father's memory in more ways than I have words to say. I hereby grant you permission to purchase property in my city. Talk to my steward if you're interested. And take this, a gift from the Jarl's personal stores. There is room in my court for a new thane. It's an honorary title mainly, but there are a few perks someone like you could make use of. However, I could only grant the title to someone who is known throughout my hold, and who owns at least one piece of property in my city. You help my people and purchase a house for my steward, and I'll make you my thane. As you were, then. If you'll excuse me, I have a city to run.
As his house, Carl, Igman's security is my chief concern.
I'm Igman's uncle. Splendid. There's a house available right now. Wonderful. Here is the key to your new home.
Held the Reach for too long. I intend to deal with them. Treat my people fairly, and I will do this. Then, by my right as Jarl, I name you Thane of the Reach. Congratulations. I grant you a personal house card to watch over your home, and this weapon for my armory to serve as your badge of office. I'll also notify my guards of your new title. Wouldn't want them to think you're part of the common rabble now. If you'll excuse me, I have a city to run.
The Silverblood family will be hurt.
May your weapons be don't bother with Tacitus. Useless.
The Jarl has appointed me to be your house, Carl. It's an honor to serve you. All right, then.